Hi, I'm Lauren with the Advising and Transfer Services Office. I'm here to demonstrate how to select course sections for your planned courses and register in student planning. A quick note before we get started, it's helpful to first review the Registration Issues to Avoid video, which highlights the most common registration issues you might come across and how to best avoid them or address them. You can find it in the Ocean County College YouTube channel in the Advising and Transfer Services playlist, so be sure to check that out, then return to this video. Let's continue with course selection and registration. After you've logged into Student Planning and clicked Plan Your Degree and Register for Classes, that will bring you to the schedule view that you see here. And here are the classes that I've planned for the semester. Now, if your schedule view has a blue box that states no courses selected for this term, and you're not sure how to select courses and add them to your plan, please refer to our Plan Your Next Semester tutorial that demonstrates how to use the progress view and search buttons in student planning to plan your next semester. You can find it in the Ocean County College YouTube channel in the Advising and Transfer Services playlist. Then revisit this tutorial when you've planned your courses and are ready to select course sections and register for them. Check the semester listed. Is this the term you're registering for? You may need to use these arrows to either show the previous term or show the next term. Now look at the sections available for each course, considering days and times, campus location, and more. I'll demonstrate with the classes I have planned here. Let's begin with CSIT 110 Intro to Computers. First, click View Other Sections to expand and view the course section options. Look carefully at the details view, which includes the course code, number, section, and title. Under that is the number of seats currently available, the instructor for the section, the days and times that this section meets, the dates, and the location that this section meets. You may have noticed that as I hover over a section in the left details view, the corresponding section is highlighted in the calendar view. Now, when the boxes are narrower on the calendar view, here for example, that just means that there's multiple sections of the course offered the same days and times being taught by different professors. Please note that there are often multiple pages to review. Once you've reviewed the options and are ready to choose, click your selection. This opens a section details box with a few additional details, such as requisites, if applicable, course description, additional fees, and more. Review these additional details, then click Add Section. This section is now planned. Planned course sections display in beige and are labeled as planned in the details view. And since this is an in-person campus-based class, it also shows up on the calendar view on the days and times the course meets. Let's also plan an online distance learning section. Take a look at PSYC 172 General Psychology. I'll begin again by clicking View Other Sections to expand and view the course section options. I'm going to choose this online distance learning section on page 5. Click on it. Review the details. Click Add Section. You can see it here on the details view. And under the calendar view, beneath sections with no meeting times. Now that all of my course sections are planned, I can register for them all at once by clicking the Register Now button. Finally, confirm that your registration requests processed. Your register course sections should display in green and be labeled as registered but not started. And that's how you select course sections for your planned courses and register in student planning.